since I was a kid in the 1940s and 50s, it was a rare treat to even see a deer. Now we have deer all over the place. And there's been an invasion, and what we have now is with these coywolves. We now have a full-fledged, legitimate top predator, mammalian predator, living in the suburbs around New York City and well into the East Coast, into the Appalachians. They are beautifully reddish. I think the younger ones, I'm beginning to think it's the younger ones, are almost all chestnut reddish brown, you know, and kind of pretty. They look like dogs. They're halfway inside between a true coyote and a wolf, the popular name being Coywolves, because they're a mixture of coyote genes and wolf genes, true wolf genes, eastern timber wolf genes to be exact. They come out naturally, occasionally, during the day. If you are lucky, you will see one. You know. So halfway inside between coyote and wolf, they behave more like wolves. Then your top object of prey is a Virginia white-tailed deer. These things are not really posing any threat to humans. And so I'm now getting treated to seeing evolution in action out here, because these creatures were not here when I was a kid. Nobody talked about them. But it turns out that their origin maybe goes back only 100 years. So I'm not a geneticist, I'm a paleontologist, but I am pretty convinced by reading the literature and looking at nature right now that I'm sitting in the middle of an exciting evolutionary event. The origin of a new species.